pump mechanical seal selection, 7 steps to select a right seal. I think you'll agree with me when I say, it's really not easy to select right pump mechanical seal. There are many things to evaluate when selecting a pump mechanical seal. You must understand clearly the anticipated working conditions so that you select a pump mechanical seal that provides maximum seal performance. And in today's post and video, I'm going to show you 7 steps to select a right pump mechanical seal. Step 1. Types. Basically, there are 2 categories of pump mechanical seals, single mechanical seals. Single seals are the most common pump seals used due to their simplicity and low cost. Regardless of their design and construction, single mechanical seals will leak eventually, causing potential health hazards and environmental concerns. Therefore, in hazardous or environmentally sensitive applications, it is better to consider the use of a secondary or backup mechanical seal mounted within the pump's seal chamber. Double mechanical seals. Double mechanical seals can be designed in either tandem or double seal configurations. In a tandem seal, 2 independent seals are oriented in the same direction and they can withstand much higher pressures in the pump casing. They are used whenever the liquid being used poses significant safety and/or environmental risks. In a double seal, 2 seals are oriented in opposite directions and there is a pressurized barrier liquid that is circulated in the cavity between the 2 seals. The barrier liquid is circulated at a higher pressure than that of the process fluid so that if the primary seal fails, the barrier liquid will leak into the process instead of the hazardous pump fluid escaping into the atmosphere. Double seals are generally used with unstable, highly toxic, abrasive, corrosive and viscous fluids. An advantage of a pressurized double seal is that it allows the use of a less exotic inboard seal material so they are less expensive to purchase and maintain. Step 2. Liquid. Identifying the exact type of liquid or fluid to be pumped is the foremost in the seal selection process. The material of the seal must be able to withstand the fluid being processed. There might be seal failure if the seal material is not chemically compatible with the fluid. In addition, you should also know the liquid's vapor pressure to ensure the fluid being sealed remains in a liquid state as it flows across the sealing faces. If ordinary liquid like water is to be pumped, then a pump mechanical seal with ordinary materials can be selected. In several water pumps, ordinary glands are used as sealants since any leakage of water to the external atmosphere is not dangerous. But there is always water leakage from the pumps using ordinary glands. Step 3. Liquid characteristics. Knowing the nature of the liquid is important to ensure appropriate seal life. For example, abrasive liquids can create excessive wear and will shorten the seal's life. In this case, use of double seals or use of an external seal flush plan will give you the option to use mechanical seals. For corrosive liquids like acids, it is important to select corrosion-resistant materials, such as stainless steel, bronze or haste alloy, for the mechanical seal. The mechanical seals also comprise of the mating surfaces and these should also be made up of corrosion and wear-resistant materials like ceramic, silicon or tungsten carbide, carbon, etc. The stationary parts of the mechanical seal can be Teflon, EPR, Bunner or Viton. Step 4. Pressure. Pressure in the seal chamber and seal size determines the type of pump mechanical seal required. The liquid enters the pump at a certain pressure and the pump works to increase the pressure to certain level so that the liquid reaches certain height. The total pressure on the seal decides whether you should opt for the balanced or unbalanced type of seal. Balanced mechanical seals, these seals have the ability to sustain higher pressures across the faces and they generate lesser heat. So, they are suitable for handling liquids that have low lubricating capacity and hydrocarbons that have high vapor pressure. Unbalanced mechanical seals, these seals are used under drastic conditions where there are vibrations, misalignment of the shaft, and cavitation of the fluid. Unbalanced mechanical seals are inexpensive, allow less leakage, and are highly stable. However, these seals work well only under low pressure range. If the liquid force exceeds certain limits, the lubricating film between the faces squeezes out and the seal fails. Step 5. Temperature. temperature plays a major role because different seal materials are rated to handle different temperatures. It is vital to know a seal's maximum operating temperature because all seal materials have an upper temperature operating limit that should never be exceeded. While some pumps handle liquids at high temperature, others handle low temperature liquids. The seal material and mating surfaces used in pump mechanical seals must be selected based on the liquid temperature, and they should be able to sustain the temperature of the fluid. You should not exceed these temperature limits of these materials, so, always provide the seal supplier with the full range of temperatures that the seal will experience. Setp 6. Material. All the seal materials must be chemically compatible with the fluids pumped through the system, which includes solvents, cleaners and steam that are introduced into the system to clean the lines. It also includes barrier fluids that are used to circulate between dual mechanical seals. When selecting the seal's material of construction, consider the following characteristics of the material: temperature constraints, chemical resistance properties, wear resistance, flexibility, thermal expansion and conductivity properties. Choosing the right materials for the hazardous liquids is very important. Otherwise, there will be chances of material failure and the liquid will leak into the atmosphere, which can be dangerous to the people handling the pump and also to the atmosphere. When selecting the face and other component materials for the seal, consider the following material characteristics: wear resistance, low leakage and friction properties, good thermal properties, corrosion resistant. Setp 7. Safety and environmental concerns. Every plant has its own set of standards and operating procedures when it comes to mechanical seal reliability and emission requirements. The seal type and arrangement selected must meet the desired reliability and emission standards for the pump application. The safety of human beings handling the pump is of prime importance. So are the permissible emission standards. To be on the safer side, it is better to use double seals that work as better sealants and are more reliable. Pump mechanical seals can operate reliably for years if they are selected properly for their application, installed properly and operated with care. So, discuss with an experienced engineer before your final selection. For more information, please visit our website online at www.noxseal.com.